Hi, this is JP Morgan. Today on Slant Lens, I've got Tatiana here with me. We're gonna take a look at a very unique lens from Tamron. It's a 35 to 150 millimeter 2-28 lens. Tamron's doing very different things. This is a lens that fits right in the middle of that Trinity 24-70-70-200, but gives you a ton of options and is very fast. We're gonna take it out, we're gonna shoot, we're gonna see exactly what it does. Unique application, let's just see how it works when we shoot. Tatiana here at the Pink Motel in Los Angeles. So I'm at 35 millimeters, that's 2.0. And from 40 to 60, I'm at 2.2, then 60 to 80, I'm at 2.5. And then when I go from 80 to on up to 150, I'm at 2.8. So it gradually jumps up about a third of the stop as you go up. I do like the fact that if I'm on 2.0 at 35 millimeters and I go to 150, it's going to stop down to 2.8. It gives me a nice option because then when I go back to 2.0, it goes back to 2.0. It doesn't stay at 2.8, which is really nice. It goes back to that shutter that I set when I first started. So the minimum focusing distance on this I have read is about 13 inches, and that looks about right when I get in on her face here. It's not a magnification lens. It's not giving you macro capabilities when you focus at that distance, but I'm getting a really tight, beautiful shot of her face. I mean, really tight. It looks fabulous. Right off the bat, I love the bokeh I'm getting. It's very soft and round. It doesn't really bloom. I don't get a lot of cat eye in the corner. I mean, it's looking really nice. Everything from that wide open, obviously you get better bokeh when you're on the longer lens, but the bokeh looks really nice. So that VXD motor is really jumping quickly from her face back to the background. I mean, it's super fast and really impressed with that. That's one of the things about these Sony lenses that Tamron's made is that autofocus is really quick. I love zoom lenses just because they're so quick. I can go in tight on her eyes. I can go back to a wide shot to see the stuff on the table. Just gives you a lot of options. 35 is a nice wide lens. It is. It's not as wide as a 24, which is probably my favorite, but it certainly gives me a nice wide view so I can see contextually what's here on the table into just a really tight shot of her face. And obviously I can get in close enough that I can focus really close on her eyes there. The color is really clean. As I look down these blinds, I just get a nice color rendition on the entire sensor. It just is clean all the way across. Just a beautiful look. I love how things are falling out of focus and I love the color rendition. While Tatiana changes to another outfit, a couple of thoughts about how customizable this lens is. It is really set up so you have a USB port, you can plug it into the computer, you can go through and you can customize all of the buttons. There's three buttons on the collar. Each one of those can be changed to do a different function. You can change the direction of the focus, you can change whether it's focus or aperture, or whatever you want to make these rings do. I love the fact that you're able to change the type of focus with this lens. You can change it from a linear focus, which is more mechanical, allows you to move in and out for video, it's much better for video, back to a non-linear, which jumps and tries to find where you're at, and that makes it great for autofocus, but not great for video. Because it is a larger lens, it comes with an 82 millimeter filter, so it's a little larger filter. So it does jump out of that kind of ecosystem that Tamron has created, all 67 millimeter. Pretty much everything they put out at this point, even for full frame or for APS-C, has been 67 millimeters. So this jumps up to 82, larger, but you need that, if you're gonna get 2.0, you gotta collect light, it's gonna need to have a larger filter size. So we're back here in the diner. We've been shooting for the last few hours, and there's several thoughts I've had as I've shot with this lens. I love the range of this lens because it gives you wide, and it goes to a much, much more telephoto, tighter shot. I get great shots of her eyes, I can get in closer. I can do more contextual shots where I come more wide. I think that combined with the fact that you can really customize this lens and make it a much better video lens as far as being able to pull focus in a manual focus mode. I think the size is heavy, but I think it's worth the glass and the speed of the lens. I feel like as I've shot with it, the breathing is minimal. I've not seen a lot of breathing. The chromatic aberration is very clean. So who would use this lens? I think it's a great wedding or event lens. Event lens is probably a great place for this because it does give you a little wider, but it lets you get in. And when you're doing events, a lot of times you're struggling to get close enough and struggling to get wide enough. So in that way, this might be a great application. It works great with strobes. It was really nice to be able to shoot everything from those wide shots into tight shots with the neon in the background. So I feel like that there's a lot of applications. People will use this who kind of want to make, they don't want to buy two lenses, 24-70, 70-200. They're gonna buy this in the middle to give them a nice broad range and to be able to get the options as a longer lens and wider lens all in one lens. So I think as zoom lenses go, this is one of the better zoom lenses I've seen in a long time. This is something very innovative and new. I think it really fits a place in the market that is interesting and gives you a lot of options for a great price. So keep those cameras rolling, keep on clicking.